just sitting here at Tamworth train station. I've got about another 15 minutes before the train comes in, which takes me to Crewe, and then on to Lancaster, and then finally into Ulverston, where my trek will begin. I'm going to do the Cumbria Way. It's a 76 mile trek across the Lake District, Cumbria. So let's hope the weather is kind, and I'll keep you posted along the way. See you in a bit.
I had a good breakfast, walked past the Laurel and Hardy statue, and onwards towards the starting point.
Good morning, my name's Daz, and I'm about to start the Cumbria Way. It's a 76 mile hike through the lakes, Cumbria, and starts in a little town called Ulverston and finishes in Carlisle. And it's Sunday, 1st of September, and this is where it all begins. So let's get this show on the road. I mean, I'm sitting at 15 kilo, which to be fair is about 3 kilo more than I wanted to be taking, but hey-o, it is what it is. You think you need what you need. So be a good learning curve for me, I think, to see what I actually can do without. I mean, we did the, my partner and my daughter, we did the West Island Way last September, which had about the same on my bag, but we used a carrier firm called Baggage Freedom, which carried our bags from one day to where you were going to stop the next night. So, and it worked really well. I mean, it weren't that dear, to be fair, but some of you purists out there were saying, well, that ain't the way to do it. I mean, it worked for us last year, but this year I'm doing this one, I'm on my own, and I'm going to carry it. So we'll see how we get on, and I'll let you know.
I followed the path alongside the stream and crossed the first bridge.
So far so good. I'm about half an hour in and the weather's looking pretty good, as you can see. You've got the Lighthouse Monument over there in the distance. I don't know if you can see that. I was on a hike up to it last night, but I couldn't be bothered in the end. I got off the train about 6:30, so I just got checked in into the B&B I stopped in last night, and then we've only got a couple of beers, something to eat, and then hit the A. But if the weather stays like this, I'm going to be a happy chappy. Like I said earlier, my pack's a bit heavy, but it's all right on the flat bits. You go on the steep bits, and you can feel it a bit. But I've noticed I've had to keep taking the pack off a few times. You come to little bits like this and through kissing gates, and you can't get through with your bag on. So, bag on, bag off, as they say. Anyway, I'll keep your date updated.
I wandered through fields, occasionally looking back at the wonderful views.
I was in nearly. Looking at the last views of the sea. Ulverston over there. Weather's holding up nice. about 5 miles in, and it's bucketing it down. We set off really nice for now.
Lovely.
A lot of cows to get through now. I think I'm going to give them a wide berth. Not really like cows. They've just decided they want to have a stand on the path. Right. I can see in the distance the mountains, and they're all bathed in sunshine. In wet rain. Right. See you later. I'm closing in on Beacon Tarn now, and boy do I need a break. It's packed, it's got to get lighter and fine on the flat bits and the down bits. It's these uphill bits. God, it just digs into your hips. There you go. Paid me money. Text me Joyce, didn't I? Got you. It ain't raining no more, stops cleared up nice. Hopefully we're still nice when we get to Beacon Tarn. We'll have a little break there. So now get the take the waterproofs off again. So I'll catch up there.
First views of Beacon Tarn and a much needed rest.
Well, just there at Beacon Tarn. I'm just sitting around the corner out of the wind. Just knocked another brew up, my coffee, a little snack. It's been decent so far. The rain's held off again now, so. That has been alright, so I'll get these jackets in a minute. It's been quite tough really. Not easy. Not hard, but if you've never had that 15 kilo on the back, it would be a lot easier. We're still enjoying it. I'm going to just slightly off the path in a minute. Right to Beacon Tarn. Apparently you can get some nice views of the Coniston Lake from there. So I'm going to, after I've had a brew, I'm going to go up that way and then head back down to Coniston. So, see you in a bit. Well, I've took a slight detour path to come up the hill next to Beacon Tarn, because you get glorious views of Coniston Lake from up here. There's a rainbow over the distance, right in the middle of the lake. Well worth the extra effort up that hill.
Beacon Fell sits at 836 feet and offers wonderful views over Coniston Water.
Up that hill there, a bit of a detour. The views were worth it. It was a bit of a climb out of Beacon Tarn up there. It was down here. I mean, I've seen 4 people all day. 4. I can't believe it really. On my own, I'd rather be on my own, so bonus. See you later. Well, on the banks of Coniston now. I've just gone past Sunny Jetty or something. Sunnybank Jetty, I think. So. However, I can't make its mind up. It rains, sun comes out, rains. I mean, it's raining now. But on some of these, under these trees. So, yeah. Getting towards the end now. Another probably 3 miles, three and a half miles maybe, along the banks of Coniston. And then I can get the tent pitched up.
Coniston Water is the fifth largest of the lakes at 5 miles long and with a maximum depth of 184 feet.
Finally got here, Coniston Hall campsite. What a day. Trudged. You have to trudge all the way down there to the shop to pay your money. And trudge all the way back again to this little campsite. Well, I've found the first pitch available through the gate, so I'm doing me. Looks dry. So I'm gonna get pitched up now and get something to eat. See you in a bit.
The tent is a Nordisk Telemark 2 and weighs in at 950 grams.
Day one done and dusted. Hoverston to Coniston, about 16 miles. Plus two going the wrong way, about. And then another 3/4 mile to the ship in. We've got some food and some beer. And then back. But that one was worth it. I had a bit of a detour when I got to Beacon Tarn. And went up the hill next to it. And you've got some fantastic views of the Coniston Lake. Which you don't normally see until you actually hit the lake. If you stay on the actual Cumbria Way path. So, yeah, all in all, good day. Bag was a bit heavier than I wanted. Hips a bit sore now. Well, not sore, aching a little bit, should I say. But I just took a couple of ibuprofen. Get up in the morning, crack on day two. Langdale's, old Dungeon Gill. There's a campsite there, National Trust campsite, so aiming for that. That's approximately 12 miles-ish. So hopefully not as grueling as today. Eh? It was a bit of a gruel really, up and down, then really rained and then it was nice, and it rained and it was nice. So I've enjoyed it though. Just like I said, just had something to eat up at the pub, a couple of nice beers, nice ales, Cumbria Way it was called, very nice. So I'm going to get my head down now and I'll see you in the morning. Go on.
Things are about to take a turn for the worst. Tune in to day two, Coniston Water to Old Dungeon Gill in the Langdales.